Hello children, in the previous class you have learned addition of two digit numbers, that is addition with bigger two digit numbers, isn't it? So I hope you understood adding two digit numbers with the taking carry also. Now let us see word problems, how to solve word problems. So here I have taken a sum, for example, okay, a seller had 38 mangoes and 29 apples. Okay, a seller had 38 mangoes and 29 apples. There are 38 mangoes and 29 apples with a seller. How many fruits does he have in all? What you have to find out here? How many fruits does he have in all? Okay, so what you have to find here? You have to find the total number of fruits with a seller. So how to solve this? What you have to do is first take hundreds, tens and ones. You have to write what is given in the sum. Okay. You have to write what is given in the sum. What is given here? It is given 38 mangoes are given and 29 apples are given. Isn't it? So write down here. To find the total, what you have to do? You have to add what is given. Okay. When you add the numbers, you will get the total, isn't it? So here 38 mangoes are given. Write it in tens and ones column. 38 mangoes. And what is given next? 29 apples. 29. Write it below. 29 apples. 29 apples. Now you have to add these two numbers to get the total, isn't it? So 8 plus 9. 8 in your mind, 9 in your hand. 8 after 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 1 carry 7. Write it here. 17. 1, 7. Now add the tens column. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. So 6. Write 6 in the tens column. So 67. How many fruits does he have in all? How many fruits are there with the fruit seller? He had 67 fruits in all, isn't it? So 38 mangoes, 29 apples, all together how many fruits are there? 67 fruits. Okay, you have to write it in sentence, that is like this. So final answer is, a seller has or else write like this. You can also write like this. 67 fruits are there in all. Okay, 67 fruits are there in all, like this. So there were 38 mangoes and 29 apples all together. How many fruits? 67 fruits are there in all, like this. So you have to write below. Let's show you second one. So it is, Ria has 34 green marbles, 26 red marbles and 15 blue marbles in her basket. Okay. She has in her basket 34 green marbles, 26 red marbles and 15 blue marbles in her basket. How many marbles are there in all? In all means all together. Totally how many marbles are there? So we know that 34 green marbles are there, 26 red marbles are there and 15 blue marbles are there. Together, how many marbles are there? You have to find the total. So what we have to do? Let us take the sums like this. So write the what is given. Write it here in the box. Okay. What is given? First 34 green marbles. So write here 34 green marbles. 26. Right below 26. Red marbles and 15 blue, right here 15 blue marbles. Now add these three numbers together. Okay. So 4 plus 6, 4 in your mind, 6 in your hand. For after 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. 1 carry, 0 right here. 10. Now add the tens. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So, 70. What is the answer? 70. So, what do you have to find? What did you find here? Total number of marbles in the basket, isn't it? So, how many marbles are there in all? There are 70 marbles altogether, isn't it? So, 70 marbles are there in all. You can write it like this. 70 marbles are there in all. 70 marbles are there in all. Like this. Okay. So, in this way you have to solve the word problems. Okay. So, first you have to write down what is given in the sum. Okay. What is given in the sum. Then add those numbers so that you will get what is asked. Finally, what is asked? You have to write it in the sentence form. Okay. Along with the answer, you have to write that in the sentence form. Like, what? How many are there in all together? What is the total? Like that. Whatever is asked, you have to write in that way. So, this is how you have to solve the word problems. So, two examples are given here. I hope you understood. Solve in this way. Okay. I'll give you sums. Neatly write down in your classwork along with these two sums. And finally, answer you have to write in this way. Take the hundreds, tens and ones column. What is given, write it in the boxes provided. And add those numbers and write it in the sentence form. Okay, I hope you understood. Thank you.